Hello, Reunion Tubers, and welcome back to Let's Play Shining Force 3 with me, Blue Ankylo. So, spoiler alert, I already accidentally recorded this one, or played this and thought I was recording, and it didn't actually save the recording. So, I might know what's happening here. But, for you guys, welcome back. Last episode, we beat up some more Rainbloods, and now we're rushing into this cave, which may or may not be volcanic, to rescue Symbios, because that's what the Queen of the Rainbloods said. It's so dark in this cave, I can't see a thing! Lord Symbios should be in here. Should we check? No, I'll just leave. Ah, uneasy because you can't see. We could use a little fire. So, Yasha, the third. The last Yasha. Correct! The others have been defeated, but I am the first and strongest. Symbios, where is Symbios? We've heard he's in critical condition. Symbios, what have you done to him? So surprised already. Ah, but there's more. More what? You are? Oh hey, look! It's the Symbios Force! Please forgive us, King Benetrim. We fell into the Rainblood's trap, and Lord Symbios was captured. They came on an Imperial ship! We thought it was Prince Medion coming to our aid, and they took us by surprise! Please, hand over Julian and Gracia to save Symbios. What are you saying, Dontres? You can't be serious! You're here, and we've asked respectfully. It's to save Lord Symbios. Please, give us those two. We don't really want to fight you.
Wait, there must be another way. Enough talk. We'll save Symbios, even by force.
Symbios army, they're serious. Yes, it is very odd that they have the same voice as we do.
Get Yasha, Julian.
The only way to save Symbios. They've no choice. Yasha is behind this.
That's it! If we defeat Yasha, we can save Lord Symbios!
The target is Yasha. Try to avoid the Symbios army. So, yeah, about that. Now, that's fine advice and all, and maybe if you're playing along, you can find a way to avoid these guys. I don't really see it happening, though. There's not a lot of room to maneuver. Also, I just did this battle, and then I reloaded the save from the end of last episode when I accidentally didn't record it. These enemies are different. Huh, I thought it would just be their A-team, but it's clearly not their A-team. So yeah, I think these three are the same for sure, the same spot. But everyone in the middle is like a random selection from the Force. I did not have Pen in the fight last time. So this makes it a little bit easier. But yeah, the problem here is getting through without killing any of them is like basically impossible. You have to defeat Yasha. He's pretty tough. You know, Rainblood tier, give or take. So that's going to take a couple rounds. Plus, there is some really good treasure in this corner, and this corner, and on this lap. So, you know, you might want to pick that up. And you move quite slowly on the ice. So I don't know. I mean, the real danger here is Mascarin's got Spark 4, which is really, really bad. Technically, Grace has Aura 4, which could heal the entire group up. And I don't know, I think if you were trying to 1v1 Yasha, if she is left alive, she could full heal him, which would cause some problems. Irene technically could full heal him, but only short range. Slow could be annoying. Most of them aren't that strong, though. Soulsteel, I didn't have to deal with Hagane last time. If he can pull out a Soulsteel, that would be really bad. Ratchet's not that dangerous. Eldar's tough, but we can exploit the flying weakness. Pen's nothing.
So yeah, I mean, that's it. We've got a force. Now, if they kill any of us, we'll lose friendship points. But if we kill them, they do not lose friendship points. So we're basically just going to take this on. We're just going to plan on killing them, really, because I don't really see a different strategy here. There may be a way to get by without having to fight them all, but I don't know how to do it. They don't have any flyers over here, do they? No. Or, I don't mean flyers, anti-flying type attacks, basically. So Dawnhorn actually has pretty bad defense. We want to keep him protected a little bit more than usual. If they want to go after Julian, that's fine. He'll be okay. Alright, Murasame comes straight at Julian, and probably Soulsteel's one-shots him, right? I was going to be rather upset if that was a Soulsteel, because I forgot to equip his knife. On the plus side, it lures him out. Or no, that's Murasame. He doesn't have... That's the other ninja. I didn't have to fight either ninjas. This'll be it. Oh my... Don't you dare. Okay, he just did physical damage. We're fine. Yeah, like I said, I just spent this battle prepping for... I just did this battle. I didn't have to deal with the ninjas at all. So I didn't even think of that. Luckily, nobody died. If Gracie had just gone a little earlier, we could have put him in this spot. And he actually would have given a luck up to both Dawnhort and Julian, and I would have been a lot more secure. Thanks to his new soulmate status, I think we can actually show this off. But as long as Gracie is in range to give his support bonus, I believe he gives magic defense and I believe plus 2 luck. Which is enough to put Julian into the safe zone. Like, being friends with Gracia is pretty solid. So can we see that reflected here? No, it doesn't show you the luck on that screen, but trust me, because he's next to Gracia, or within 2 squares of Gracia, he will get 9 luck. And that should be enough to protect you from Soulsteel. Alright, it's gonna be like that. We can't even really get close enough to do much right now. But yeah, last time I did this battle, they didn't have ninjas, so they didn't have a way to cross the ice quickly. Now that's kind of pathetic, Murasame. We didn't have an easy way to get across, basically, so it took a lot longer to get into the combat. I already knew the Symbios army would lose. You made it through Maya and reached Arctil. The Julian army must be the most powerful. We are. Clearly. Alright, we have to kill Hagane. We can't risk him getting a Soulsteel off. Like, that's the problem, is how do you ignore these people, right? Especially the ones that can just cast Soulsteel. So, I feel like we just, you know, he has to die. Defeated by the Julian army, my ninja technique needs much work. I'll give you some advice. Don't underestimate Yasha. As a ninja, he has many excellent ninja skills. Is he a, what's the word? Splendid ninja? Okay, so my strategy here, just to let you in on the details, is to use the blue dragon to lure out a spark from Mascarin and then kill her before she can use it on anyone else. The blue dragon has a ton of HP and should survive one... Spark 4. Also, seeing as they're all grouped up. Somewhat grouped up. Whatever. Get out of here, Penguin. Basically, nobody likes you. So, just die. I wonder if you bought Pendol, if you could recruit... Pen. Not that I care. I'm just wondering if maybe that's possible. This is not the time or place for defeat. Push yourself to the limit. Chirp, chirp, exactly. Alright, Spiriel. You know, Frank is pretty cool, but... Got like a bandana. Be awesome. Oh, is all he says. Alright, well, we're in a pretty good spot. They get a couple attacks in here, but we should be fine. That could do some damage. Yeah, halfway dead. Half expecting these guys to start leveling up, beating us up. Alright, well, we could kill the bird, or we could make sure everyone's at full HP, so we'll do that. You know, like, I guess if the enemy force was controlled better, like by a human player, this actually would be quite a difficult battle, not to win, but to win flawlessly, as in not lose any of your characters. This would be quite difficult, because I think, you know, if I controlled the Symbios Force, I'm pretty sure I could get a couple kills here at the very minimum, just by grouping my people up and, you know, focusing down Bridget and Isabella or something. In fact, I might even be able to focus down Julian quick enough that technically I could win if I set it up properly, you know. When the Median army attacked Aspia, our reserves had to engage them. Now we're battling Julian, fighting against allies again and again. Could the Symbios army be cursed? You just keep falling into traps, basically. Trusting the wrong people. We're up a little bit. One of these days it'll select you. Yeah, Julian needs some HP. We want to save our MP because, what's his name? The third Yasha. Yasha the third. I am. He's pretty tough. Did I show you guys the stats? I can't remember if I did it on this recording. But, yeah, Yasha 460. Kepyudo is a range 3, large area of effect spell. Kind of like Bolt 3, I guess. Except it also locks you into place. It gives you the frozen foot status, which is kind of rude. I'm not a huge fan. Alright, so there's not too much left that they can do to stop us. Irene is not that strong. We do need to kill Grace, unfortunately. I think I'll send 1,000 over to the treasure. Oh, there's also Ratchet. Alright, Mascarin's not gonna move out yet. I'm thinking of saving some of Bridget's MP for, Yasha. How much do you think we should save? I mean, if you could put all of them to sleep, you could avoid having to kill them all, but... I know I gave a lot of this force the Artemis pins, although not, Irene. But... anyone with, like, 6 or 7 luck is probably going to be immune to sleep. So, like, I was not going to be able to put them all to sleep, even in the best-case scenario. I mean, I guess we'll try. Just for fun. It doesn't have very good success rate, even at 5 luck. Trying to finish the battle as soon as possible. Even if it means eliminating the Symbios army, huh? Is that your plan? How foolish, Julian army. If you defeat me, what will become of Symbios? That's certainly something least imaginable. I'm right here if you think you can defeat me. Just go ahead and try it. Well, at least he's full of confidence, one way or the other. Is this gonna get too close? Maybe. Yeah. Let's not move Spiriel up past Ratchet until Mascarin has had her turn. Ratchet. Good defense. Solid defense, buddy. Oh, yeah, she's starting to attack. Alright, so... actually, she could hit... dang it, I didn't even count properly. She could technically hit Spiriel from there. Alright. Julian's gonna go pick on the healer. Now, Grace is at a pretty high level, so I guess we're getting XP from that. That's kind of fun. Alright, yeah, we gotta finish Ratchet off.
That's nothing to worry about. Too much of the Symbios B team. I was hoping it'd be all A team.
My modified this power armor into the greatest battle machine. Why is it still no match for the Julian army?
I barely remember the voices I was using for everybody. Now, Isabella, do you have any spark resistance?
You do.
Okay, you know what? If she takes a hit from spark, she'll be okay. Also, I can double up on this. Can't I? This one. There. Alright, so if Mascarin goes for the spark on even Spiriel here, she should be okay. You know, it's one of those spells I don't use very often. It is really good, but just the opportunity to get it cast in preparation is difficult. And I'm not hugely surprised that she went after Julian here. Irene was never that good, you know. She was useful as the second healer, but that's about it. Don't think you can move far enough to hit Honesty. Actually, you could. How much HP? 71? Well, you got a little bit of spark protection. We'll wait to pick up the treasure in the corner because I don't want Honesty to die. Okay. There's not much Gracia can do. Produne, probably useful to wrong weapon. Probably useful to finish off Gracia if we can, or Grace if we can. Gracia and Grace, yeah. No wonder I'm always confused about these names. But if you can kill her, I guess. I just don't want her to have the chance to start healing and buffing people. It'll just drag the fight on too long.
Because of the Rainbloods in Yasha, we were forced to battle our allies. Please forgive us.
Alright. Well, 1,000, definitely go pick up some loot.
You got Orichalcum!
Alright. This is a good spot. Leon the Lion King. Might as well try out his Apollo Axe. We haven't really even used it very much. Not bad. Alright, here we go. So now the goal here is, if possible, if I'd thought about it, I guess I could have planned on using the blue dragon to block Mascarin's path so that Honesty would be safe, but that's fine. If Mascarin wastes her spark here, then we're in totally good shape. Yeah, I mean, it does a lot of damage, don't get me wrong, but the blue dragon, I've never seen Spark 4 do 120 damage, so I figured we'd be okay. Can't get close enough to hit Mascarin from here. Might be able to take Dawn Therese out. Thing is, Bridget... Oh, you know what we should do? Before Irene dies, let's see if we can steal some of her MP. Nice! That spell is really good. Alright, now... You know what? I'm willing to send in Spiriel this way. She's got magic protection on right now. If she could kill Dawn Therese right away, that'd be great. And I think even Yasha... I think that's the... Yeah, I think that was the Orichalcum or Tier 3 or... Maybe not. No, it's not Orichalcum Mace, but that's a special mace. That was the weapon skill for it. How could I be defeated? The Julian army is certainly strong. I failed to keep my word to Yasha in exchange for the life of Symbios. How regrettable. But yeah, I figured we'd be fine there. Just trying to decide how I want to spend the last of my MP. I don't know if Spark 4 will be enough. Actually, she's only got 39. Actually, that's almost certainly enough. Just gotta make sure we equip the right weapon. Actually, there's another weapon that might do comparable damage. I just want to see what the weapon strength is on it. Or the magic strength, that is to say. So Zephyrus 2 is 15 MP for 64. I bet you Mascarin will have more spark protection than wind protection. And this saves us a little bit of MP. And I think it'll still do 40 damage. She'd need like 50% wind protection to not die here. Yeah, not even close. She probably doesn't really have any wind protection at all. Nice to have a good selection of spells.
The Jillian army is too powerful. I couldn't even kill one dragon.
So we didn't kill Irene in an entire round. That was my bad. But, like, it's not really a big deal. So now we need to start talking about Yasha here pretty quick. I guess I'll just let Julian kill the poor, helpless monk girl. Doesn't even know how to speak English properly. Poor kid.
I have a feeling Sensei is near.
Sensei? I don't know. It's probably Sensei.
Even fight me over food when he's hungry. What greedy one. But I really wish to see him again.
So, I'm not 100% sure who her sensei is. I don't think it's Jubei. I was thinking originally the first time I played that, well, maybe if you brought Jubei, you could have talked to her. But I'm pretty sure that he is not her sensei. Her sensei is a different character that really likes to eat food. And we may have met him previously, if you remember, somewhere. Alright, so we're going to actually stay a little bit spread out. I'm going to hope that the boss comes towards Julian so we can sort of surround him. Also, we got to grab some treasure. I will keep Gracia kind of on Julian's, like, protection. Because I would not be surprised if the boss goes straight after Julian, basically. And some magic defense might not be a bad idea. Alright, Produn. Like I said, I'm just trying to keep people back so that wherever the boss moves to, we can get sort of surround him next turn, is what I'm hoping for. He may just target the big group at the back, but that means he has to get pretty close to us. In case he goes after Medion, or Julian, whatever his name is, we'll give him the defense bonus there. And in case he goes after Bridget, we'll just protect her. And we'll pull the blue dragon out of the way. Alright, so he just went for a physical on Spiriel? Well, that's not going to do too much. I thought he'd go for the big magic attack, but, well, that'll teach him. Okay, so time to get serious here. We've sucked all of the MP out, which is also very fun. I should leave Bridget in a location where she can spread her magic boost to a couple people, like Gracia and Isabella, so they can do more damage. And maybe we'll be able to kill this guy in one round. 460 HP sounds like a lot, but, like, when you can do, I don't know, 50 to 80-ish damage per attack, and you've got 12 people, like, it's very difficult for him to even survive a full round, right? Like, I think the bosses would need to have around 1,000 HP at this point in the game to really stop us. Or just have a lot more physical defense. Like, if he had, like, 80 defense, he might be able to stop us for a while. But, so we could go with Zephyrus, but I think, technically, we're going to get more damage out of Spark 4. Unless he's got, like, Spark protection, but I don't know. I have no idea what Yasha's magic defense looks like, so we might as well just go with the stronger spell, I guess. That's pretty darn good.
Alright, there is also one last treasure here, and unfortunately we're out of inventory space. But it should be fine, because if we drop it... Well, we could just drop the small mithril too, but it doesn't really matter. I think if we drop it here, it'll just end up in the deal section. So as long as you find it on the map, you still end up... You know, you'll get to keep it. We definitely want to switch Spiriel's weapon, though, if we're going to keep her up front like this. He's using a sword, so the halberd will give us a bit of an advantage. And if he can do 35 damage with weapon advantage, he will not be able to do as much next turn, assuming he survives long enough. I'm actually going to... Oh, wait. No, what am I thinking? I was thinking I would do a melee attack. No. No, this is going to be the best amount of... The highest amount of damage is to use that... Oh, I should have equipped... Dang it. The Rune Blade gives you a bigger magic bonus. We probably could have gotten very close to 100 damage there if I'd used the Rune Blade rather than the knife. My bad. We might have him right here. Did we ever decide if Shining 2 or Blessing 2 did more damage? Like... Shining 2 is 32 for a large AoE and all of your MP. I bet you Blessing does more damage. I mean, I don't know. Maybe Shining gets extra damage depending on how much MP you've got that it burns. But I think Shining is like his upgraded special spell that he got from being promoted. So maybe it's supposed to be stronger. I don't know. Not quite enough. I guess, I don't know. Maybe Shining was the right choice there. I don't know. It shouldn't make a big difference, though. Prodoon! Yeah, you know, this fight was a lot like how we rescued you, so why don't you deal with it? Yeah, you got Lord Sword. It's pretty good. Gold Rush! Just really... Just demolish him. There you go. And you're even friends with Gracia. Not too shabby. Also, he had, like, Blaze 4 now, right? So he's got a pretty good magic spell as well. If I put him next to Bridget. The Bone Eater, I suppose... I think we've already got one, but it's better than a healing item anyway. Alright, well, that's that. That wasn't too bad, right? Unfortunately, we had to wipe out Symbiosis' force. We defeated Yasha and the Symbios army. Come, let us hurry and save Symbios. I've lost the Julian force. Ugh. What? Yasha still has the strength to stand. He should be... What terrifying strength. We Yasha, with hopes of becoming the strongest ninjas, continued training even after leaving the ninja village and becoming rogue ninjas. But our end, defeat. Because we admired Rhodey, we three brothers learned the art of Trinity. Now none are left. I don't know who Rhodey is, and I don't know what the Trinity is either. Julian, do you know this ninja named Rhodey? No. Actually, Julian might, but I don't. You guys don't. We learned a lot about the world, and how meaningless it is to live by ninja law. With our ninja skills, we didn't belong in any country, so we decided to become rogue ninjas. The art of Trinity is the most secret of all ninja techniques. We were dishonored for assassinating the Lord of the Far East and taking the secret scroll. These acts enraged the assassins of the ninja village. We couldn't live up to Rhodey's success. We ended up serving the Emperor. Rogue ninjas claim no country. I've heard ninja laws are very strict. You must have suffered. I don't need your sympathy. I'm dying. But not alone. Symbios is going with me.
Going with you? But he's still alive, isn't he?
Ask someone you can trust about the situation Symbios is in. Otherwise, you'll be mourning the deaths of Symbios Palsis and the others who are sealed. Self-destruct, initiate. You know, I was thinking there for just a second that the Art of Trinity is probably what let the Yashas communicate with each other instantly, so that nobody knew there was three Yashas, and even though they could be in three places at once, they all sort of
mostly could communicate with each other. That's exactly what Jumsin needs right now. We just don't know it yet. The cave opened! What's going on? Oh, good. The other guys survived. Yay. King Benetrim and the Julian army. I see. You came to look for us. Gracia, it's been a long time since we... Oh, right, that's Con. Gracia, it's been a long time since we last met. Also, did you kill our entire army while we were in there?
It's been a while, Con.
Yasha is gone. Was he defeated?
Yeah, Yasha, it's true then.
Yasha has been defeated. How could this happen? Is what he said true? That he holds the life of Symbios in his hands? Yasha used a secret technique to seal Lord Symbios in this ice. Only this technique can release him. It's a good thing we've got a bunch of ninjas in our force. One. He's losing heat and air, but melting the ice with extreme heat will kill him. What if we use Blessing? Or Egress? Egress always works. Just keep casting heal on him. Let's have Bridget, you cast Blaze 1. You can equip a rod and equip and cast Blaze 1. And then Gracia can just bless them over and over again. And we'll have Isabella on aura duty, and he'll be fine. That's why we didn't attack Yasha. We needed him to free Symbios. Now, there's no way to save him.
There is a way.
Where there's a will, there's a way. Well, hello there, Innovator Vandal. We've read about you. Or is she just Vandal Mortal? I don't remember. Some combination of bloodlines. Jane, why are you here? What? How rude is that? Like, seriously, Jane has been helping us out for a long time. And he's like, why are you here?
Jane, is there really a way to save him?
Jane, who are you anyway? Why do you want to help Symbios?
But if I melt the ice, he'll be immersed in dark water.
Right. Don't worry, Julian. I understand. I'll save him. But it'll take both Gracia and I to save Symbios.
Both of us? What do? I'm dumb.
Well, I'll melt the ice, and you immediately cast Blessing on the dark water. Don't be stupid, child.
I don't understand, but I'll do it anyway.
Pretty sure I predicted that someone had to melt the ice and someone had to bless him. So, you know, just get to work. There. Don't talk about it, just do it. Now, bless the water. Thank goodness he didn't have a 5-minute discussion about whether or not he should bless the water.
Don't stop!
Oh, she doesn't like being blessed. It's bad for her. She's mostly Vandal, remember. Someone should maybe check on Jane. Good job, flying bros, though. You saved the hero.
Hurry! Take him to Dormont's hot spring!
Yeah, Jane, you okay over there?
No, every time I see you, this happens. Are you alright? I don't understand. Don't worry, I'm alright. I must go now. See, look, I can float again. It's alright.
Well, you do appear to be floating again. I guess that's a good sign.
I'll see you again after I've healed.
That's fun. Jane, such an incredible girl? The strange thing is, how could anyone be hurt by the warm light of the Staff of Besom? Really? I guess he's been locked in a cave for a while, so he must not know the whole story.
I don't know, because I never know anything, but she's helped us before. She also had the Vandal voice before, and I'm pretty sure she's related to the Vandals in Remotest, but I'm not telling you that right now, because I'm dumb.
Gracia, has your power increased?
Yeah, I'm an innovator now. I'm a real boy.
True innovator power? It's a long story, Palsis. Really, we don't need to go over it again. The audience already knows about it. We'll tell you off camera. Yeah, we can talk about this later. Let's hurry up and save Symbios. Thank goodness. How is Symbios doing? What a convenient plot device that there was a miraculous healing spa right next to someone who was about to die. The hot spring has healing properties. Symbios is waking up. Indeed, we just dumped him in there and hoped that he would not drown. It's amazing. It's a miracle. He may be awake, but he was trapped in ice for a while, so he won't be ready for battle yet. I'm fine, Benetrim. I can continue on. Lord Symbios, you shouldn't exert yourself. You haven't completely recovered yet. How do you think you will be able to fight? But I can sense that Julian has a special sword for me that he brought from across the country. Look, I'm standing. Just a little longer. Give me the sword. Well, at least you survived, but we didn't expect you to be able to depart at once. That is impossible. As long as you stay here in the spring, you will recover. Then you can join us in the battles ahead. Just don't get lost again, silly boy.
It may be a good idea for us to stay in Dormont to protect him.
The Medion army! Something serious has happened! Oh, good. Has something bad happened to Medion as well? Also, no horses allowed. No horseplay in the spring. Bazinga.
What happened, Don Hort? What's wrong with the Medion army?
Well, as we went south, the Dystonian fleet continued north.
Well, that must have been Big Brother! They decided to continue to Remortis since we left before they did.
Except you can't get to Remortis by sea because of the frozen North Sea. Remember, we read about that in the book?
What do you mean?
Two ships passed Dormont at different times. Well, there are still two Rainbloods left. Yes, the other two Rainbloods, the King and the... what's left? Killed the Rook. Whatever the other chess piece is that we haven't beaten up yet.
They must have been the Rainbloods.
Yeah, blah, blah, blah. You guys know what's going on. King and Knight, thank you. Thank you, Banatrim, for clearing that up. They must be furious about their losing their companions. Now they're going to go beat up Medion, probably.
It must be a trap!
Well, there's only one thing to do. I guess we'll have to go save Medion as well.
It's a shame about the Symbios army.
Having, you know, killed most of them and all. But we'll follow Medion north. Proceed, Benetrim. We know the Rainbloods are a grave threat. Please, save them and just leave my sword by the springs. I'll get it when I'm ready. Yeah, as soon as I've recovered, and I can pick up my sword that you brought for me. How come no one's mentioning this awesome sword?
Symbios has made his decision. You don't have to worry about him.
Yeah. Let's quickly hurry up and go north. Yeah, I got it. Alright, well, I will do a little bit of town exploration on the next episode, just because there's a couple new things to talk to, but for the most part, we're pretty much done in Dormont, and we're going to head north to go, you know, meet up with Medion, or probably save him from a trap. But that can wait for the next episode. So thanks for watching, hope you've enjoyed, and see you next time.